The editorial process I found fascinating, largely because it was my first time. I've never had anything that I've written be read by somebody else at such a beautiful, forensic, close level. So it was amazing. It was like somebody gave me new eyes to see my own work. In terms of how my book changed from manuscript to final product, the main thing, and the thing that I really laughed about with Catherine, my amazing publisher, is like, if she had 20 pages of notes on the novel, for example, sort of 3 pages were about the beginning and 6 pages were about sort of the middle bit. And the part that I had been trying to hide from myself from writing, that I hadn't gone into and written, there was suddenly like 11 pages of notes, as if I'd sort of cloaked everything in darkness, but Catherine had walked straight in with a torch and shone it exactly on the thing that I was trying to just sort of like, I'll just put some shadows over here and I'll just put some, and nobody will know. But it wasn't, of course, a fully conscious thing. It was that way that my subconscious was trying to maybe protect myself from the last level of vulnerability and digging and sitting in it. You know that great saying about the author is the one that stays in the room. And in that area that Catherine sort of wanted me to pull out more work from, I did not stay in the room. I stuck a toe in the room. I occasionally stuck a hand in the room, but I did not stay there. So the main change between the manuscript and the final book is that there is a part in the sort of second third of the novel where I wrote 10,000 new words and can now hold my head high and feel like I stayed in the room. And that's probably the biggest change.